During opening arguments in a medical malpractice case in New York, can I tell the jury the specific facts that support our claim? In opening arguments? Would you like to learn the answer? Come join me for a walk as I share with you the answer to that question. Hi, I'm Gerry Oginski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. The answer is yes, that is exactly the time that I want to share with the jury the exact facts that support our particular claim. During jury selection, when the attorneys are trying to determine which jurors are right for your particular case, we are not permitted to talk to the jury about the facts of your case. We're not allowed to. If I start to talk about the facts, my opponent will get up and scream and yell and object, and now we'll have to go see the judge, and the judge will have to make a ruling. And the ruling will be, counsel, you can't talk about the facts of this case. Why not? It's because many of the key facts in a medical malpractice case are, in fact, disputed. We claim that the doctor violated the basic standards of medical care. The defense says, wait, what are you talking about? No, I didn't. I did everything right. Okay, so that's fact number one that's disputed. Number two, we will claim that the doctor's carelessness was a cause of your injury. And the doctor will turn around again and say, what are you talking about? Whatever I did not cause or contribute to your injury. So that's disputed as well. And number three, we are going to claim that whatever the doctor did wrong caused you harm and that your harm is significant and permanent. And guess what? The doctor's going to turn around and say, listen, if I did something wrong and I caused you harm, your harm isn't that bad. So we have clear disputes here. And now, why can't we discuss the facts during jury selection? It's because we're not in court yet. We're in a small room in a jury selection room designed to pick a number of jurors, six jurors, who have told us that they can be fair and impartial. Well, if we can't talk about the facts in jury selection, what can we talk about? We can talk about the fact that this is a medical malpractice case, a medical negligence case, and now we can start to delve into the jurors' backgrounds and whether they have any experience being jurors and things of that nature, and how they feel about certain concepts, about people who bring lawsuits or about people who are sued. So it's important for us to talk to the jury to find out what's in their background. But the jury room is not the place for us to talk about the disputed facts. Why not? It's because it's not the courtroom. And there's no judge there. And there's no judge to make rulings on the various legal issues that arise. So we're told, do not talk about the facts of the case. So now during opening argument, when the judge tells us and says, Mr. Oginski, you may begin your opening argument, guess what? That is the exact time that I want to start telling the jury exactly what happened and exactly what the facts are that support our particular claim showing that the doctor was careless and that his carelessness caused you significant harm and injury. So why do I share this quick information with you? I share it with you just to give you an insight and an understanding into what goes on in these medical malpractice cases, especially opening arguments in New York. You know, I realize you're likely watching this video because you have questions or concerns about your own matter. Well, if your matter did happen in New York and you have not yet started a lawsuit and are thinking of doing so, but still have questions that need to be answered, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day and I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at Gerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at oginski-law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Gerry Oginski. Have a great day.